So wait, does everybody know what like sucking your teeth is when someone goes like that? It basically signifies like disgust or frustration or, you know, just general annoyance, right? That's what it means. Well, you'll never hear me do it. You never have and you never will. And the reason is because my mother hated it. I mean, it was truly her pet peeve. It was worse than a pet peeve. It was basically a death wish with her. And my mother was tough. I mean, she was a Haitian immigrant. I mean, born in Haiti in a house. You know, legend has it, she bit off her own umbilical cord when she was born. Just ready to go. But she was really, really tough. I remember growing up, you know, the beatings I would get became legendary, and other kids would console each other when they got in trouble, like, hey, at least you ain't got Chris's mama. So it was really tough. And I remember I was about 12, maybe 13, about 12 and a half years old, and I was in trouble for some type of school-related misbehavior type of thing, and my mother was pissed, really mad, really disappointed in me. And she was going off, and I guess I was having a really bad day too, because out of nowhere I went, and I'm telling you guys, my mother was the Mike Tyson of ass whooping. So I had never wanted to rewind time so much in my life and take that back. And as I was just thinking about the regret that I had, I saw her hand raise and start coming toward my head. And that's when the unthinkable happened. I caught my mother's hand. They're like goosebumps right now. I caught her hand. And as I was holding this weapon of mass destruction, I thought to myself, wow, so this is how it ends. You know, it's been a great 12 and a half years, but there was so much I hadn't seen, so much I hadn't done. Like, what was sex like? Like, what even goes on down there? I had no idea. And so I did what any warm-blooded kid would do. I ran to the bathroom and locked the door. And so I'm in there, and I know I was delirious because the first thing I was thinking was, you know, is there some type of escape hatch or like a back door I can escape through and never come back? That was my first thought. And then, you know, there was a knock at the door. Christopher, my fuck, full name. I knew that she was all business. I look around the bathroom and I thought again, I'm like, you know, this is my home now. I realized I had clean water. The tub could double as a bed when I got tired. It wasn't so bad. And then I heard her rattle the door. I tried to get in and she said it again, Christopher, open the door. And I know I was delirious because I started having xenophobic thoughts. I'm like, I don't know what you people do in Haiti, but here in America, we have rights. I'm like, I've never seen her papers. She's here taking people's jobs. I couldn't think straight. I was so terrified. And but I knew that time was running out, and I had to open the door. And she knocks again, and she says, Christopher, open up. I'm not going to hit you. My mother wasn't a liar. My mother wasn't a liar. If she was gonna whoop that ass, she would tell me straight up, "I'm gonna whoop that ass." 3 o'clock. So I got my bravery up. I thought this is a good day to die, and I opened the door, and I saw her empty-handed. And my first thought was manual asphyxiation, typical mom. But she reached out and she actually she hugged me. And I was real confused by that. But she said that she wasn't going to hit me and that she wasn't going to spank me or beat me ever again. She said that I was of the age where she would talk to me now and we would have discussions. And as a single mom, she was always really, really tough on me because, let's be honest, as a black boy growing up in the D.C. area, things would be tough. And there would be times that I had to be twice as good just to be seen as on par. And she just told me all these different lessons and really explained why she was so difficult in times where I kind of got out of line. And I understood. But the most important thing is I wasn't getting my ass whipped no more. I remember bragging to my sister about that. So till this day, like I said at the onset, you won't hear me suck my teeth, no matter how frustrated, no matter how upset I get, because My mama taught me better than that. That's it.